We are learning more and more about how contamination can enter the barn through the entrance room and how important it is to consistently implement biosecurity protocols at the barn entry. For example, studies have shown that avian influenza virus, which is now found in higher concentrations in the environment, can survive on rubber boots for up to 3 days. Let's run through some examples to see how bacteria and viruses can be tracked into the barn using different barn entrance designs: a red line, a step-over barrier, and a bench. Glowgerm is a liquid and powder product formulated with particles about the same size as bacteria, approximately 5 microns. With the help of an ultraviolet light, it simulates the spread of germs, showing how quickly and broadly germs can be spread, and how effective or ineffective our sanitation practices are. First, let's see how well a typical hand wash may work, with washing for about 10 seconds. Now, let's start over and wash for the full 20 seconds, following public health guidelines. Much better. There's a couple issues with this. A line with no other physical barrier is easy to ignore, such that boot changes will be more easily forgotten. Additionally, the red line does not prevent dust and debris, which can contain harmful viruses and bacteria, from blowing across into the restricted area. A step-over barrier that is flush to the ground and reasonably high will do a much better job of preventing organic matter from the controlled access zone coming into the restricted area, if it is used correctly. The main drawback of the step-over is that it's easy to ignore, and therefore doesn't help with boot biosecurity compliance. As you can see, even a one-time quick check on the birds can bring contamination into the barn. It's important to avoid using the step-over to help remove outdoor shoes or boots, as this can bring pathogens into the restricted area. When used correctly, let's see how the step-over works. Having a full bench in place is a best practice for preventing organic material from the controlled access zone contaminating the restricted area. When designed and used correctly, this is a great way to protect your flock. Benches that have any gaps, either between them or under them, may still allow organic material from the controlled access zone to contaminate the restricted area, potentially bringing in harmful bacteria or viruses to your flock. Even a well-designed bench, if not used correctly every time, can allow for cross-contamination. It's important to ensure feet do not touch the ground on either side of the bench while changing boots. When designed and used correctly, let's see how the bench works. Thank you. With migration patterns and virus spread, the contamination level of avian influenza in wild birds is expected to remain high for the foreseeable future. Due to this increased disease risk, all stakeholders should be critically analyzing their biosecurity practices to be as prepared as possible. An improved barn entrance design is one of the most impactful biosecurity changes that can be made on farms to prevent cross-contamination and introduction of harmful bacteria and viruses causing disease.